Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In 15 minutes or less, you can boil yourself a nice cup of tea, or you can spend your time learning some German and practice your A1 and A2 comprehension skills. Let's go! So this week we have again a shopping situation. This time it's the boys. Karim and Thomas are looking for a gift for Anastasia's birthday. Let's see what they find. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want more free content for learning German in an easy and stress-free way. Wir hören den Text. Leg das besser wieder zurück, sagt Thomas verwundert. Wieso? Das ist doch ein tolles Geschenk, erwidert Karim. In seinen Händen hält er einen Kalender mit Katzenfotos. Anastasia hat doch eine Katze. Ein Kalender ist das langweiligste und unpersönlichste Geschenk. Na gut, aber langsam müssen wir uns entscheiden. Wir suchen schon 2 Stunden nach einem Geschenk. Karim hängt den Kalender wieder an den Haken. Ja, ich habe auch keine Lust mehr. Ich hasse Shopping. Die Jungs laufen in den nächsten Laden. Was mag Anastasia denn? Was sind ihre Hobbys? Sie kocht gerne, oder? Zu Ostern hat sie uns Eier geschenkt. Nur weil sie uns einmal Eier geschenkt hat, kocht sie nicht unbedingt gerne. Ein Buch vielleicht? Sie sind in einem Bücherladen angekommen. Sie studiert doch BWL. Schau mal dieses Buch. Das große BWL-Lexikon. Ja, gute Idee. Thomas dreht das Buch um. Ey, 57 Euro kostet es. Das ist ja heftig. Karim hat eine Idee. Wollen wir es ihr zusammen kaufen? Und eine Karte, die wir beide unterschreiben? Gute Idee. Dann müssen wir nicht noch ein zweites Geschenk suchen. Komm, wir gehen zur Kasse. Endlich sind wir fertig. Zufrieden bezahlen die beiden das Buch und laufen zum Schreibwarenladen. So hat Thomas kein besseres Geschenk als ich, denkt Karim. Okay, we will read together. This is the part where I also speak English to explain to you vocabulary, grammar, fun facts, anything else. Let's start. Sorry, my voice is a little strange. I'm sick. So this is why my voice is deeper than usual. Leg das besser wieder zurück. Here we have a separable verb. It doesn't look like it, but it is. Zurücklegen. Zurücklegen means to put something back. Besser means better, and we have imperative, so we don't have a subject, because it's giving an order in an unpolite or informal way. Put it back. You better put it back. Wieder means again. Says Thomas, verwundert is like confused. So, you better put it away again, says Thomas, confused. Don't forget, by the way, you will find my A2 and A1 grammar course, which is completed by now in the playlists. They are a great addition to your studies because they are really complete A1, A2. And if you check them out and learn with them, everything we talk about here, or 95%, would be familiar, grammar-wise at least. Okay, next one. Wieso? Das ist doch ein tolles Geschenk. Why? That is a great gift. Doch, here again is something that's hard to describe. I talked about it before. Doch is a convincing word. It's a filler. If someone says something negative, we want to say, though, it's good though, it's a great gift though. This is this kind of doch. Erwidern is to answer, to react, to say something back. So why? It's a great present though, says Karim. In seinen Händen hält er einen Kalender mit Katzenfotos. In his hands, and this is dative, even if it doesn't look like it, in his hands he holds a calendar, akkusativ, with Katzenfotos, with pictures of cats, mit, again, dative. Anastasia has a cat. Anastasia hat eine Katze. Again, doch. Is a try of convincing someone. She has a cat, so it's a good present. Next one. Ein Kalender ist das langweiligste und unpersönlichste Geschenk. Langweilig means boring. Unpersönlich means unpersonal. And STE at the end makes it superlative. Again, check out my A2 grammar course. I talk about it. So, a calendar is the most boring and most unpersonal present. Na gut, okay then. Aber langsam müssen wir uns entscheiden. But slowly we have to decide. To decide is a reflective verb here. Sich entscheiden. And the subject is wir. We have to decide. Entscheiden is our verb. And the object is reflective and therefore uns. Wir entscheiden uns. We decide. So it's reflective. We have to decide slowly. It's interesting now that I say it. Here we have slowly, but in English you would say soon. So slowly is an adjective, is langsam, but in English when we say we have to do something soon, we would say aber langsam müssen wir uns entscheiden. Wir suchen schon 2 Stunden nach einem Geschenk. We're looking for a present for 2 hours already. Learn it as a pattern. Nach etwas suchen. To look for something. I know you most likely learned that nach means towards. For example, er reist nach Brasilien. He travels to Brazil. But it's not always like this. This is why you need this practice with the real German. Nach etwas suchen, to look for something. Karim hängt den Kalender wieder an den Haken. Der Haken, male, means the hook. So Karim hangs the calendar, Akkusativ, an den Haken. This is also Akkusativ, because it's a Wechselpräposition. Wechselpräposition, we also covered. It is a preposition that can be accusative or dative, depending on the verb. So Karim hangs the calendar again to the hook or on the hook. Ja, ich habe auch keine Lust mehr. Yes, I am also not in the mood anymore. I'm over it. Die Lust, female, by itself means the lust. But most likely we use it like mood, to be in the mood for something. And we have a negation here, so we would say in English, I'm over it also, I don't want to do it anymore. Ich hasse Shopping, I hate shopping. Die Jungs laufen in den nächsten Laden. The boys walk into the next store. Again, in ist Akkusativ. In den nächsten Laden. Why? Because the verb is a movement A to B and therefore this Wechselpräposition needs Akkusativ. Was mag Anastasia denn? Was sind ihre Hobbys? What does Anastasia like? What are her hobbies? Then is a filler word. It's giving a sense of urgency or not knowing what to do next. What does she like though? What can we do? A little panicky, it sounds almost like, but we don't have to say it. If you say, was mag Anastasia? It's almost the same. Sie kocht gerne, oder? She likes to cook, right? Gerne, to like to do something with a verb here. Zu Ostern hat sie uns Eier geschenkt. For Easter, she gifted us eggs. This is another story. If you watch my story playlist, you will see that. So here we have perfect tense, hat geschenkt. And also the object here is in dative, to gift somebody something, uns. Nur weil sie uns einmal Eier geschenkt hat, kocht sie nicht unbedingt gerne. Only because she gifted us eggs. One time, einmal, doesn't mean, we don't have it here, but that's what it means, doesn't mean she has to like cooking. Unbedingt means like certainly or for sure. In a negative sense, because we have the nicht, We negate the whole sentence. It doesn't mean that she likes to cook for sure. Ein Buch vielleicht? Maybe a book? Sie sind in einem Bücherladen angekommen. They arrived in a bookstore. Here we have in with dative. And now you think, why is that? To arrive is a movement. Grammatically speaking, it's not. They arrived at a bookstore. Sie studiert doch BWL. Schau mal, dieses Buch. She does study economics. Check out this book. Doch, again, it's a little bit convincing. We see this example quite often today. So she studies economics. Check out this book. Das große BWL-Lexikon. The big BWL-Encyclopedia. Ja, gute Idee. Yes, good idea. Thomas dreht das Buch um. Separable verb. Umdrehen, to turn around. Ey, 57 Euro kostet es. Ey is youth language. Yeah, it's slang, I wouldn't say, but we don't say it too often as grown-ups. I mean, I'm over 30 and I still say it almost every day. But don't go by me, try to avoid it. So, ey, like, wow, it costs 57 Euro. Das ist ja heftig. Heftig, another adjective, means like extreme or crass. Yeah, something like this, also youth languagey. Ja doesn't mean the ja we say every day, ja or nein, but it means something like very or just for emphasis. You can remember. It's also an emphasis for something unexpected, a little unexpected. For example, your friend cooks something really nice and you try it and you say, das schmeckt ja gut. Yeah, this tastes good. Better than expected, a little bit. Karim hat eine Idee. Karim has an idea. Wollen wir es ihr zusammen kaufen? Do we want to buy her it together? So here we have many short words. Es ihr. With es, we mean of course the book. And with ihr, we mean her. This one is dative, by the way. And this one is akkusativ. Und eine Karte, die wir beide unterschreiben. And a card, which we both sign, unterschreiben, to sign. So, after the noun, we have a comma. And then we have a further explanation. This is A2+ grammar. But I think you can handle it if you want to try. Don't forget or keep in mind that the verb is at the final position. A card that we will sign both. Gute Idee, good idea. Dann müssen wir nicht noch ein Geschenk suchen. Then we do not have to look or to search a second gift. Ein zweites Geschenk, a second gift. Here you see the preposition nach is not always needed. If we wanted to say it, we would say, dann müssen wir nicht noch nach einem Dativ zweiten Geschenk suchen. This would be with nach a preposition that needs Dativ and it would change the whole grammar after it. This is where I always tell you, learn the articles. Komm, Imperativ. Gehen wir zur Kasse. Come on, let's go to the cashier register. Endlich sind wir fertig. Finally, we are finished or done. Zufrieden bezahlen die beiden das Buch und laufen zum Schreibwarenladen. Content or satisfied or happy, depends how you want to translate it. Both of them pay the book and walk to the stationery store. I don't like this word, but this is what it means. It's like the store with paper, pens, cards and stuff like this. And maybe you say now, wait a second. Laufen is a movement from A to B, classical movement. But why is it dative? Then I must say, sorry, not sorry, it's not my fault. But zu is not a so-called Wechselpräposition. It cannot be changed into accusative. It's always dative. Yeah? So therefore, it has to be zum. So hat Thomas kein besseres Geschenk als ich. So, it's like in English almost, that way, Thomas has no better present than me. Comparing A to grammar, E-Mail Playlist. So, that way Thomas has no better present than me, thinks Karim. Maybe because he has a little crush on Anastasia, I'm not sure yet. You can let me know in the comments below. This is it for today. Thanks for watching, learning with me. Please subscribe, like the channel, leave your feedback, and don't get frustrated with the prepositions. I know they are a pain, but the more you do these exercises, the more you will use them correctly. I will see you very soon. Bye!